the next video where I want to show the first stage from a very simple shortwave radio. It consists of a field effect transistor here, and after that a normal NPN high frequency silicon transistor, the BF194, that is set to amplify in a very good way. And it's very important to tell that when you want to connect a coil like this to a radio circuit, the coil is sensitive at a certain frequency. It has all to do with the physical properties, the length, the diameter, the wiring, the amount of wiring, the thickness of the wiring, the ferrite rod inside, or whatever. And in the old days, such a coil could easily be connected to the grid from a tube, but nowadays that is more or less difficult when you want to use a normal standard NPN transistor. The impedance here from the base to the ground is far too low, and that will damp the coil, take the coil out of its resonance, take it out of its frequency band where it has to work. So that's a big problem. But the good solution, the best solution for that, is to use a field effect transistor, like I've done here, the BF256A. Bought on the free market, and it's a very good high frequency field effect transistor. It's here in the circuit, this one. By the way, this is the coil, the best coil that I found out in a quick way for between 14 and 18 megahertz. You see the thickness from the wiring, how that coil was made, and here are the important things to tell: the length, the diameter, the thickness from the wire, made from red copper, blank red copper. The coupling capacitor will also have to do with the frequency where it all works, but this works good in this frequency band and 14 to 18 megahertz, and I've connected that coil to a long wire antenna inside the house. When you want to connect an antenna outside the house, use here a switch that switches the gate directly to ground when the radio is not in use. Otherwise, due to static charges on the antenna, the field effect transistor will surely break down within a few months. I've done many experiments, and that's my conclusion. So anyway, with an antenna inside the house, no problem at all. You can you don't need here a switch to shortcut the gate to ground. This is a very simple circuit. The BF194. And here I use two potentiometers. This is the first one. It's a preamp high frequency setting that's necessary. Sounds strange, but it's true on the basis of my experiments. And here the real aligning from the high frequency amplifier. So here you can set the volume from the high frequency amplifier. So that was more or less all to tell. And I found that I could receive new radio stations when I bridged the VFO coil with a bunch of capacitors. The frequency went down to 15 megahertz anyway. Doesn't have so much to do with this video, but perhaps interesting for people. people that want to make this radio, rebuild this radio. And I wish you luck. Radio technology is extremely interesting. Always interesting when you succeed in making an old school analog shortwave radio.